My name is Michael Musimov. I'm the CEO and co-founder of DrChrono. We build a mobile electronic health record for the iPad, as well as provide a wider operating system for ambulatory care. Just a quick intro. We're Meaningful Use certified by InfoGuard Labs. We have over 85,000 medical professionals on our platform and over 5.5 million patients. For the last 2 years, we've been on the Inc. 500, and we're ranked by Silicon Valley Business Journal, the fourth fastest growing private company in Silicon Valley last year. So healthcare infrastructure is in transition. We're going from paper-based models that have been dominant for decades to what I'd call EHR 1.0, which is electronic health record systems doctors will use that are basically barely functional. I compare it to email in 1990 that was used at universities with things like Pine and text-based email clients compared to Gmail today, 25 years later. We're moving to a mobile model. And I feel mobile is really the only platform that's going to matter in EHR over the next 5 years. We were ranked the number one mobile EHR by Blackbook Rankings for the last 3 years in a row, including 2015, since they started tracking the category. We launched on the iPad from the ground up in April 2010, right when the iPad came out. And it's the right platform to go after. 80% of U.S. physicians own an iPad. That number goes up to over 90% when you consider an iPhone or an iPad. To quickly tell you what the iPad EHR does is everything that a doctor needs to do when they're in the room with the patient, they'll do on the iPad. They don't need any paper or prescription pad. They don't need a desktop computer or a fax machine. They'll be able to view a patient's history, quickly build the clinical note with our touchscreen interface and our medical speech-to-text engine. They can send a prescription to any pharmacy in the U.S., send a lab order to any Quest or LabCorp facility in the U.S. and a growing number of third-party labs, and even send a referral. And I think most importantly, to sum it up, once a doctor leaves the exam room with a patient, they've had a good experience because they've used a very streamlined mobile EHR. They don't have their kind of back facing a patient, throwing care over their shoulders. They're engaging with a computer. But they're also done with their visit. They've finished their clinical note. They've triggered all their billing codes. And they've started all the follow-up care for that patient. We kind of see mobile EHR as a beachhead into the broader ambulatory market. We essentially give away this award-winning mobile EHR for free. You could go on the App Store and download it for free and start using it in under a minute. And where we monetize is by taking over a doctor's medical billing and revenue cycle management. And we really see, you know, at the end-to-end, we also give an app for doctors to interact with all of their patients. And we have really the best API in healthcare, and I'm going to drill into these topics more. Our medical billing and revenue cycle management side, to give a point of reference, we have over $1.5 billion in medical billing claims flowing through our platform every year right now, and it's growing very quickly. And for the typical doctor, if we take over their billing from in-house billers, we're showing a 20 to 30% increase in that doctor's top-line revenue, which is really important because it keeps these doctors engaged. They're seeing more patients, and they're staying in business. They're not retiring and getting out of medicine because it's too tough to run their business. On the patient side, we really want to provide, you know, as a patient, what I want from my doctor is I want to use my iPhone or my mobile phone to schedule appointments, to communicate with them. We have over 5.5 million patients on the platform. And we let patients put in their credit card to help them pay their medical bills and help reduce doctors' AR times when they're collecting co-pays and statement balances. And I'm going to break up the presentation by showing a quick testimonial video from one of our doctors.
My name is Cesar Javaharian. I'm an emergency room physician, and we use DrChrono in our urgent care practice in Berkeley, California. In addition to our standalone clinic in Berkeley, we have a mobile clinic. And DrChrono's EHR allows us to not just take care of people in the office, but also at their homes. And that sort of flexibility has been really a key feature. Because we're a fairly high volume clinic, the efficiencies that we're getting from using iPads, from being able to document on the fly, has been really wonderful. Some of our providers prefer to use the iPad in their documentation. Some providers prefer to use the website. And having that flexibility to really meet the needs of our providers has been very helpful. Adopting DrChrono is actually an easy process. So we allow our staff and our providers about a day of hands-on training with the EHR, and the rest of it is fairly intuitive. So they can pick up how to document on the fly, where they can go to find information on labs or x-rays, things like that. The DrChrono platform has so many advantages compared to other EHRs. I'd say the main ones being that you can choose to do documentation with your patients at the bedside, as opposed to having to always be tethered to a computer in some office. If I were to guess, I think that most patients would prefer to have their clinicians with them documenting as opposed to behind a computer screen. So about a year after we opened up our practice, we switched from the traditional billing team to the DrChrono billing team. The DrChrono billing team has had in our practice has been tremendous. We've seen about a 30% increase in our reimbursement from insurance companies without really doing anything else other than working with the billing team to optimize our documentation and identify areas where we were missing out on reimbursement.
Great. You know, working with doctors like Javaharian is really rewarding. It's why I work so hard on DrChrono. You know, if you check out Dr. Javaharian, he's in Berkeley, California, Director of Urgent Care. If you look up his Yelp page, you'll see he has 700 five-star reviews from his patients. It's because he really cares about the patient experience. He's using a great EHR that doesn't get in the way and isn't hostile to him treating his patients. And he doesn't have any of his staff really focused on billing. They're all focused on customer experience, dealing with the patients coming in, and he's a great doctor. I wanted to talk about our API. I feel like in any other industry, you'd assume there's a great API you could build stuff on. It's really rare in healthcare for a number of reasons. There's a lot of walled gardens, and I really feel we've built one of the best APIs in healthcare, and we have dozens of startups and dozens of our customers building on it. We help a doctor with their marketing needs. They can use ZocDoc and Demandforce to get new patients and reactivate patients and help patients follow up with care that they may have fallen off from. We have appointment efficiency. There's billions of dollars in productivity lost from canceled appointments that don't get filled. So there's three different platforms that a doctor can choose from on our system to help with rescheduled appointments. And basically, whenever there's a cancellation, they'll text message people on a bump list or who are scheduled further out to reactivate them. And in clinical innovation, there's dozens of different startups. There's not going to be another EHR here for the next 10 years. The barriers to entry are way too high with meaningful use. And we're seeing a ton of innovation in really deep clinical verticals. I'll just talk about one today. Echo Devices, a really small team of five people with a few doctors, they built a small dongle that can screw into any stethoscope. And what it will do is record the heart rate as a pediatrician is listening to a child's heart. And it can really help a doctor send that heart wave to a cardiologist for a referral. And without the need for an in-person referral, they can diagnose that 99% of heart murmurs are not really necessary to have follow-on care. They're kind of very benign. And they can really help isolate that 1% of heart murmurs in children where they really need a cardiac intervention. Data backup and access. I think this is something that's a no-brainer in most industries, but is surprisingly lacking in healthcare. We partnered with Box to back up all of a doctor's clinical data in Box in real time. And we also have a great API. And I think that leads into a lot of our customers. There are dozens of companies out there doing an Uber for healthcare. And they're all predominantly choosing us as their platform because this API lets them build this great consumer tech where I press a button on my iPhone and a doctor will come and see me in my office, at my home, at a hotel I may be staying in to treat me and my family. And we're getting a lot of great companies like that building on us because of our API. It really lets them leverage all that we've built in our EHR and medical billing. So to summarize some of our strengths, we increase the number of patient encounters a doctor can see in a given day. We improve provider EHR satisfaction, which is really important at larger groups where providers are employees of a group. We decrease the time spent documenting clinical notes. A doctor doesn't have to sit around for 2 hours at the end of their shift finishing all the notes they just started and took brief notes on. They're completely done with their iPad right when they walk out of the room from the patient. We also reduce the amount of time they spend fighting their EHR in front of the patient. They spend a lot less time typing away and documenting and more time focused on the patient and seeing more patients per day. We're increasing the top line revenue of ambulatory practices, which is really critical to keeping a strong independent ambulatory market, which I think is really key to providing good levels of care to everyone across the US. We decrease the amount of staff that has to be dedicated to billing, in most cases zero. We decrease unpaid and rejected claims. We drive up patient engagement by having them on board with our on-patient product before their visit and while sitting in the waiting room, they can be handed an iPad. And also after a visit, they can engage with onpatient.com. And we decrease late and missed appointments. Through our API, I think we're doing a lot of things. We're helping them increase their revenue through marketing tools, which is really, you know, kind of surprising that doctors never had to worry about marketing themselves before. But the marketing forces have changed, and doctors really need to fight to increase their patient volume. And we're decreasing, you know, along with our API, there's going to be a Cambrian explosion in startups that are building deep, really great clinical integrations. And we're getting dozens to launch on our app store this fall. And we're really reducing all of the IT costs and security audits and HIPAA audits the doctor and the clinics themselves would take on by merging together a bunch of different technologies by signing BAAs with all of our API partners and making it all work for them with one click, where they're using single sign-on from their DrChrono login. They could log into all of those API partner services I highlighted before. Thank you.